Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff's son.
Fun.
This is the Atari plug-and-play TV games. This is from JAKKS Pacific. They have a whole line of these. If you take a look at the back of the box here, it shows the games that they have. These are like Atari 2600 type games that they came out with, making it look like Atari 2600 games. And that's the box right there. If you take a look at the instruction, it's very basic and simple, but it goes through each of the games and different settings. So the games like Breakout, well, they have a breakthrough where it shoots through the walls and invisible stuff and different games and so forth. So this is kind of like nice to be able to go in depth in the games right there. This right here is the whole unit. It looks like an Atari 2600 joystick. On the front, you have just a fire button and the joystick right there, which is the way they're supposed to be, none of this joypad crap. In the front you have off and on, reset, select, start, and right there you have the on button. So we're going to turn it on, and there you go, it pops up. The little red light comes up, and then after the opening there, you can go between the different games. You go up, down, left, right. To go back to the screen at any time, you just hit reset, and it goes right back to the screen. And you can hit the fire button to speed it up. During the game, you hit select, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can select between different games, and they all have like multiple games. And once you get to the game you want, you hit start. And then after you hit start, usually it's all controlled up here. Usually the fire button starts it. So let's go through some of these games really quickly. We're gonna start off with Adventure. And I'm gonna show off here because I remember this from the day. You go up here and you get the key. So you press the button to get rid of it. And this is a sword. You get the sword. You go down here. There's a dragon. You kill the dragon. You can drop that off. Now, for some of you that may have remembered, right up in here, there's no Easter egg. You can't make that wall go away. And you go over here and you kill this dragon. And you go back. And as in an adventure game, it's pretty faithful to the Atari 2600 version, which, by the way, was one of the best 2600 games there were. And so as you go through this, you have different dragons and so forth. And this is a really cool adaptation of the game. And this is the only one that I'm really going to go through the whole way. So you go up here to the black castle, and there's a magnet. You go up here and you grab the chalice, and the object is to get this chalice back to the beginning. Now there's three different settings, there's three different games on this, so you can play the one that you want. So you bring it back, and right there. And that is how you beat Adventure on Atari 2600. Now let's go through some of these other games. You come back here, you hit reset, and you choose between one of the other games. So let's go to Asteroids. Asteroids is like an Atari 2600 version. Now there are different versions of it. You can go through the select. We'll go through, pick different selection, hit start. Now here, if you press down, you get a shield, which is kind of nice. See, this is my favorite. I didn't particularly like the hyperspace. So if you press up, you thrust, and then left and right, you fire. So that's Asteroids on the system. Let me go over here and have the shields. Alright, here we go. Hit reset, and we'll go down to Breakout. Now Breakout on this is kind of tough to play. I don't particularly like playing with a joystick because it's too tough. You go, see, he's doing like little increments there, a little bit. It's really tough to play. And let's try a different game here. We'll go down some and see what this one does. This is an invisible Breakout. it's actually Breakthrough. Breakthrough, it goes through all the bricks there. So there's that one. That's Breakout. We'll go down to Centipede. And Centipede on the 2600 looked really stupid. And, you know, they didn't really have to make it look this bad. But this is kind of what Centipede looks like and looked like on the Atari 2600. So let's reset it. So here we go. We'll go down to the next one, which is Circus Atari. Now, Circus Atari was one of my favorite 2600 games. And you go back and forth here, and you have a little guy, and they go back and forth. And they have this thing at the bottom there, which you should use a paddle. And playing it on this game with this joystick isn't that good. But you play it on a 2600 with a paddle, and this is like a really fun game. And depending on where the guy lands on the little seesaw, he shoots up higher or lower. And you're trying to hit those balloons at the top. So it's sort of like Breakout in a sense, but a much, much better game. And there's different variations of that. But this is it's really tough to play on this, but it's a great game on the 2600. All right, let's take a look at another one. We'll go over to, we'll skip Gravitar. We'll go down to Missile Command. Now, Missile Command is more like the 2600 version, which was a decent version. One of the reasons why I bought a 2600. Now you'll notice at the bottom center there's only one place where the missiles come out of, and that's it. There's not three. That's how it was on the 2600. Even the 5200 version was like that. So there you go. That's actually pretty faithful. I mean, this is a pretty good game for a little joystick game that it is like this. So let's take a look at another game. We'll go down to Pong. And we start that, and here we go. Now, this Pong, you get to play against the computer. This is kind of weird playing this with a joystick and not a a paddle controller. If you take a look at my review of all of my Pong systems, there are some that have a knob that goes 360 degrees, sort of, and other ones that are slider bars. This is more like a slider bar version. It's too tough to actually play. Let's go down to Volleyball. This is kind of a dumb game. When you start it, I'm playing the blue guys, and I get the volleyball, and I volley it to them. Now, I've always said that if you're going to play, if you're going to have a 2600, you're going to play games like Space Invaders and Centipede. You're not going to play volleyball. You know, it's kind of a dumb game. But, you know, for the time, it wasn't that bad. You know, it was an okay game, you know. And we'll go over to Yar's Revenge, which a lot of people love. You're the guy on the left, you know, firing over there, and they're gonna shoot this thing at me there. And that's actually pretty faithful to the 2600 version. I mean, it's very, very close. All of these games are pretty close to the 2600. If you take a look at them, like, well, that's halfway decent. Oh, I missed it. And there we go. And the last one is Gravitar, which was my favorite game out of these. Now, Gravitar, you have like a little solar system there, and you're supposed to go to each of these planets. You can't hit the sun. So, and as you're doing it, you have these UFOs that come at you. And if you go to the sun, you get killed. And as you go into each of these planets, you have to set off the reactor. And blow these things up, but you only have so much fuel, which is indicated this the top center there. And this is a very fun game, particularly for the 2600. This was a cool game back in the day. It's a cooler game today. So there you go. That's that, and that's all of the games for the TV games, the Atari TV games from JAKKS Pacific. A really, really cool thing that you just take the plugs and you plug it in. I got to plug it into a recorder, but it's got a few feet here, so it doesn't use a 2600 TV switch. It just uses a standard composite, which is your video, and has one for audio, so it's in mono, it's not in stereo. And you just plug it in and go, and it uses batteries. You just unscrew it right there, and you put a few AA batteries in there, and you go. And it's really cool. You can play it at home, you can play it at work, or wherever. That's the Atari TV games from JAKKS Pacific.